I've been a very severe critic of scientism. I believe one of the greatest diseases of the Islamic world, much worse than the malaria that is attacking East Africa, is scientism. Scientism, from which governments as different as Saudi Arabia and the Islamic Republic of Iran, as Malaysia and Egypt, all suffer from. All governments support science without knowledge of what it is. They want power, power and wealth. That's understandable. But the intellectuals who support it believe that through science comes power, and therefore this is Islamic. And God says you should pursue ilm, and science is ilm, and therefore science is Islamic. Whereas a science in which the existence or non-existence of God is irrelevant, in which you can be a physicist and be a good Catholic, and you can be an atheist and be a good physicist and win the Nobel Prize. Such a science cannot have any place in Islamic civilization. Very few people have the courage to say this. But I'm now at the end of my life. When I was 25 years old, I said that, and I still say it. We need to understand that scientism is not possible to accept. Most of Muslim intellectuals really worship science and technology. They say they worship God. Yes, a few hours a day. The rest of the day, we worship science and technology. And this is the great malady of the modern world. The environmental crisis one day is really going to take good care of us, and people will stop this worship that now is all over the world. It's not only in the Islamic world. It's in Hindu India. Look what's happening to India. The land of Shankara, what is happening to it now, and it's, of course, in communist China, where from the time of Mao Zedong on, of course, Western science was really the god, and the Chinese have put that in front, but they consider it to be communists and atheists, and they don't have ideological differences with it as we do. And we should be very, very careful about this scientism.